Hello everybody, welcome back to another Premiere Pro tutorial. In this one, I'm going to show you how to do custom picture in picture effects. In this case, I'm going to do it with a circle with a nice cool stroke on the edge of it. And I'm also going to show you how you can move this around without having to move the underlying footage. Let me show you what I'm talking about. I'm going to hit spacebar. She's just doing her thing. Presto, I moved her, or animated her in this case, to the other side of the screen. And if I double click on her, I can just move her to wherever I want her to go. Now, that's interesting, I think, because this is the underlying footage, and you'll notice here that I'm not moving the underlying footage. I'm just moving her face and her body without that underneath it. So this is a very cool circle crop custom PIP. Now, let me show you how I did it. I'm gonna hit Command Z, so I'm just gonna go back to where we were before. And let's just actually delete everything here. Let's go through it step by step, why not? Okay, let's start from scratch. The first step, drag and drop in the underlying footage. This is very popular for people that play video games. If you're a gamer, or if you're an educational, you teach educational videos and you want your face to pop in and pop out, or you want to move it around to get around, you know, parts of the of whatever you're teaching, or the blackboard if you've got a something like that. This is very, very popular. I'm just going to go ahead and reduce this to about 5 seconds of footage because I just want to show you the technique. The second thing, grab the video that you want to sort of picture in picture on top of the underlying footage. In this case, it's this lady here, and presto, I'm just gonna go ahead and reduce her down to the same amount of time. Now, let's see what we've got here. We've got her, and okay, she's looking good. Oh, she might need to take more fiber. Whatever, eat more fiber. Anyways, let's get going. So the next step here is I'm gonna go ahead and click on the top image, or the top video, pardon me. I'm gonna double click on it, and I'm just gonna go ahead and reduce its size so it's a little bit more manageable. And then let's say I'll move it over here to start. We're gonna be able to move this in a second, but I just wanna be able to work with this a little easier. So I'm gonna move it right to here. And now what we're going to do is we're gonna go to our effects panel. It's, for me, it's right here. If you don't see it, go to Window, make sure there's a check mark beside effects. Under that, you wanna grab the crop effect. So in the search bar here, just type in crop, and then you'll see here under video effects, transform, crop. Drag and drop crop on top. And out of the box, it does nothing, but if you go to your Effect Controls panel, Window, make sure there's a check mark beside Effect Controls, just like that. For me, it's right here. I'm going to scroll down and I'll see Crop. Now, I can do custom cropping here if I want to, if I want a rectangle or a custom look, I want a triangle. But in this case, I'm going to create an ellipse, so I'm going to create a circular crop. So I'm just going to click on that button one time, and it's going to apply this very strange and narrow-looking ellipse, and that is actually not what we want. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hover my mouse over here, and I'll zoom in post-production, and you'll see I've got an arrow with a little circle underneath it. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to hold down the shift key, and when I do that, I'm just going to pull on one of these different edges. So I'm just going to pull the edge, and I'm going to try and figure out what size of picture in picture I want. So let's say I want to go with something like that. So I'm going to take that and let go, and now we've got a circle, but we haven't, again, we haven't done what we need to do yet. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to move it. So you'll just see here that I just grabbed it and I moved it over her face just like that, and then I'm going to let go. Still not where we need to be, but there's a few more steps we gotta take. The next step here is I'm gonna go ahead and reduce the mask feather. I'll show you why in a second here, but we'll just work through this sequentially. Now, in the next step, watch this. I'm gonna click on the inverted button. And still nothing's happened, but not to worry. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna jack up the left, top, right, and center here to 100%. Once you do this, you'll see where this is going. So it's already done its trick, but I just do this just in case. I'm gonna put them all at 100%. But once you've done that, you'll now see that we've got this cool little circle crop. We have the inverted button clicked. We have the mask feather off. If we had feather on, you'll see here that it kind of makes the edges sort of glowy. But in this case, we want a hard edge, but I want you to know that that exists. And then you can also expand the mask if you want, if you find that you've maybe made it too small, for example, or too big. You can just go ahead and expand it in here, but I'm going to leave it as is. And now watch this. Before I go any further, I'm just going to go ahead and double click on her face here. And oops, I got to click out. I'm going to double click on her. And now watch, pardon me, I can move her around. And again, the footage that it's based on is not moving. It's just her face with the circle. So that's kind of what we want. Now, if we want to go a little bit further and we want that cool little twitch or streamer, you know, I guess you'd call it edge to it, you can go ahead and type in paint bucket. Oops, let's just see. I'm just going to type in paint. This is effects panel. Type in the word paint, and you'll get the paint bucket effect. This is also not, this is kind of counterintuitive, but I'll show you how to work through it. So we're going to go ahead and apply it to her, and it makes a very weird looking effect. Not to worry. Go back to effect controls. Go down to where the paint bucket effect is applied. And what we need to do is we got to go ahead and go from color and alpha to alpha channel. Switch that up and then switch it from stroke, from anti-alias, back down to stroke. And when you do that, you'll see there's a very thin little stroke around the edge of that circle. So we've kind of got that edge on the edge of it here. And now I'm just going to go ahead and jack the width up a little bit so you can see a little more. Sometimes it takes a few seconds for this to kick in because it is quite a heavy duty. We've got a lot of effects running here, so you can sort of see that it takes a few seconds for it to think it through. And you'll also see that this line at the top here has gone red. That means it's a little bit more than my computer can handle without going away from the RAM. So there we go. We've gone ahead and added in that little stroke on the outside. We've got everything pretty much where we want it to be. If I double click on her face here, for example, I can move it over here. And that is literally how you do a picture-in-picture, custom picture-in-picture effect, crop circle effect with Premiere Pro. Thanks for watching.